Before I begin this video, I realize that Shadowlands is on the prowl. In fact, it's noted that the devs will likely be releasing the beta soon in about 3 to 4 months, give or take. But that's still 3 to 4 months of a problem not being fixed that I think should be addressed in some way, shape, or form. As you all know, I'm not the biggest fan of Battle for Azeroth. I never have or ever will be. I think it's probably the worst or second worst expansion this side of World of Warcraft, but that doesn't mean I don't get involved in the competitive gameplay from time to time. There's an issue on both sides of the coin here, and I'm going to try to explain the problem that's afflicting both ends of the spectrum in a reasonable way, that being the PvP situation and the PvE situation. I addressed this problem on my stream at twitch.tv/camxgame, where I was basically talking to someone about how keystones can be ruined by a singular person in a way that no one can control or mitigate. And I'll go ahead and stop teasing you and tell you what that way is. In my opinion, the number one worst thing that can ruin a competitive gameplay scene is if someone leaves in the middle of it. That's really about it. Think about it. If someone leaves, a lot of times, it's a guaranteed failure. Now, you might be asking why I have such a pessimistic outlook on this issue. When it comes down to it, competitive gameplay that includes rated battlegrounds, arenas, and mythic keystones, in my opinion, has no failsafe in place if a pug decides they don't want to participate in that activity anymore. Now, some people have squads that they can rely on to play games with, and that's fine. If you have a team that you can run with, it is all the better for you. But most rely on group finders and puggings in order to get a progress in this game. And I need you to go ahead and do me a favor. Picture this situation. You have a level 8 mythic keystone that you want to progress further for better loot, but you don't have a team who can reliably come to assist you on it. So you open up the group finder, find a similar team that is leveled up to about your item level, let's say, and head into dungeon. You go in ahead and buff up, put the keystone in and start the timer. All of a sudden, the healer decides he's not feeling it and dips out. And just like that, the keystone is over. There's no way most people can handle a loss of a healer or tank, or even a DPS at a higher ranking. Now, why is this an issue? There are a few reasons. Firstly, once you put the keystone in, you basically can't get another person into your group. The game locks any other players from coming in to join on the team. So if someone decides to leave, you're just down to 4 players. It doesn't matter what that case may be, you're down to 4 players. Secondly, that person and everyone else who participated in the keystones just wasted some potential food buffs, potions, and other things to do the dungeon. Those things, depending on your server, are not cheap. Not everyone's an alchemist or a cook or an enchanter, and that means you're going to have to rebuy those items. But the biggest kick in the nuts and the thing I primarily wanted to address today was the fact that the person leaving has no repercussions at all. If the person who decides they want to bail simply leaves the group hanging, there's 0 penalty to that person. Nothing. Not a single ounce of punishment to that person at all. They just get to move on and possibly go to another mythic group or do whatever it is people like them tend to do. This means that in theory, you can actually join groups, decide you don't want to do it, bail out, and leave the whole group stranded in no way to complete the dungeon. It's a sin that someone can simply leave what is a competitive part of World of Warcraft and get no real penalty for it. The game has never really had a built-in mechanism for the competitive aspect of things in that regard, but it's especially apparent in this time where group finder and anonymity are at an all-time high. This seems to suggest that World of Warcraft is in fact more delved towards casual gameplay instead of the competitive side, even though both should have a form of balancing to ensure that both can be comfortably played. Yet right now, the only difference in penalties is set for casual. What I mean by that is, let's say you queue up for a random battleground. You join and either go AFK or you decide you don't want to do it and hop out. When you do that, you get a deserter buff that lasts for about 15 minutes, meaning you can't queue for BGs or arena skirmishes in that time frame. Casual dungeons, once you queue in the group finder, if you leave them prematurely, you have a 30-minute debuff that disables all functions of doing any casual dungeons in the long run. Arena skirmishes, well, if you decide to leave one or don't join the queues, you do get like a 1-minute debuff, and if you do it again like 5 and it stacks up to 15, but that's not really a big penalty in my opinion, and it really shouldn't be for casual players. Meanwhile, on the keystone sides, if you leave one, nothing happens. If you're part of an RBG pug group and you see your team is losing, you decide to go ahead and leave. Nothing happens. Arenas are kind of the only real stipulation, but even then, like I said, there isn't really much of a penalty in there anyway, so it's not like you're gonna basically get anything from it, so I'll go ahead and say nothing happens when you leave an arena. This is a backwards ideology, because most games have the reverse, where if you leave a casual match, there is either a small or no penalty. But if you leave a ranked match, you get a certain penalty. My example for this is Rainbow Six Siege, my second favorite game that is quickly becoming my favorite due to World of Warcraft's current standard. For them, if you join a quick match and decide to leave, there is 0 penalty. That's fine. A casual match, it doesn't mean anything. It really doesn't. If you leave one, no big deal. If you join an unranked match, which is kind of like a hybrid of casual matches and ranked matches tied into one, you get an abandoned penalty of 30 minutes at the start and more depending on your past penalties. Finally, if you join a ranked match, you not only get the abandoned penalty, but the game limits your ability to gain renown, which is basically the currency in the game. Your elo becomes more limited, which helps you rank up, and the match is still counted as a loss, regardless of whether or not your team wins that particular match. I'm not saying that Siege is a perfect game. By far, it has its issues, but at least it has some satisfaction in knowing that someone leaves, they're going to be punished for doing so. This alone at least shows that Ubisoft is doing what they can in their game to stop people from leaving the match. Taking into consideration the other on the team over one selfish individual's desires to leave a match and by extension leave the team in a worse state. Blizzard, however, doesn't seem to have fallen from that perspective, opting to push casual players with a very light bans while competitive ones are thrown to the wayside. So, I don't know what can be exactly done about this. Is there really anything I could do? I'm not a designer or programmer at the HQ, and ultimately, I don't know how difficult of an issue this would be to fix, because circumstances do happen where someone may have to leave a keystone in case of an emergency. But in my opinion, something should still be done here, and I do have a couple suggestions for Blizzard in case someone ends up watching this. My first idea would be to have a soft penalty for players. This was more drawn up by the person I was talking to in my 34-hour livestream, but basically if someone decides they leave, they'll get a permanent sticker to their character or account for the rest of the season stating they left the Keystone, Battleground, or Arena prematurely. What this sticker does is it alerts other players that this person is potentially unreliable, and therefore they should pick wisely on whether or not they should take them. I know there's something called Raider.io, which basically kind of does that for you already, but I want to go ahead and address Raider.io. The thing about it is you don't understand the circumstances of what happened within the dungeon. It just shows you the dungeon itself. So to say that Raider.io kind of already does this is not really fair, because let's say you have somebody who knows a route perfectly and like a level 10 plus, you're going to end up having them be punished because the DPS decided to be a little bit too low, or the healer decided to run around and meme on the actual run itself. It's not exactly a perfect system by any means of the stretch. Yes, Raider.io is important, but it's not something that I would rely on entirely for this kind of deal. This is more for people who decide they want to go ahead and punish their other teammates by leaving prematurely. But honestly, to me, that's a little bit too soft. It would psychologically have players make better choices due to the fear of possibility of being unable to progress their character, and I'll say that that's a positive on my end. Of course, a player could appeal this in case there was an emergency where they had no choice, and Blizzard could ultimately decide to remove the abandoned sticker if they deemed it necessary to do so. This would probably have some drawbacks because, like I said, it'd likely be that someone would have to have a direct attention towards a keystone and other competitive gameplay, and when I say that, I mean somebody at Blizzard HQ. But in case of actual issues that went on in the group, you'd have to go ahead and verify whether or not you'd want to lift that ban. The second idea I have, and this is what I'm more in favor with, is along with the soft reset. For that week that they decide to abandon a match, they get a reduced chance of raising their keystone or getting an MMR. Meaning if you're in a keystone, you get a debuff that reduces your chance of getting a gear by a certain percentage. And while the rest of your group gets a keystone level of whatever time limit they finish by the end, you get one below that. So let's say, for example, you decide to do a 10, you put in your keystone and the group finishes it with only like a plus one. That means that to you, it'll just be another plus 10 and you can't really progress that keystone any higher. Same thing with like lower level keystones and higher level keystones. That could be a real pain for somebody who is trying to push a keystone. The only downside to this, I believe, is, you know, somebody I guess could just run other people's keystones, but with the abandoned sticker, it would make it much more difficult to do that. As for raid battlegrounds and arenas, I'd say if a player leaves prematurely on those, they get an MMR limit for that week, meaning they do not gain as much for winning those types of PvP. I'm thinking a 50% or maybe 40% reduction would be good, as it'd have people waiting until the battleground is over, or at least, you know, close to over before they could leave. Also, your conquest could be limited alternatively to gain a certain percentage in order to ensure that getting gear would be limited. Finally, if we're really against punishing players who have left the team high and dry, then let's give the players an option to fix the predicament at hand. For the Keystone players, let's give the level Keystones back to the person who put it in and allow them to find another person after they reset it. This would mean that if someone puts in a level 7 Keystone and someone decides to leave instead of getting a level 6 Keystone, if they fail, they get another shot with the same level 7 Keystone. As for ranked battlegrounds and arenas, I'd say if you wanted to go on this route, then just limit the amount of MMR loss to the other team. If they are put at a disadvantage to win, then let them not suffer because one pug decided to go ahead and leave the vital match. My problem with this last one, though, is that it can be easily manipulated. Say a team is doing badly, so one person decides that in order to save their keystone, they'll leave the group. The rest of the team then goes back a little later and tries that same level keystone. Alternatively, Raid of Battlegrounds or Arenas could have this happen where one team sees they're losing and decides to bail prematurely, so the rest of the team's MMR isn't scored to oblivion. That's why I'm not the biggest fan of this idea personally. I don't know how it could be developed, but if the team was adamant enough, they could probably implement something into effect so that way this kind of manipulation couldn't happen. But that's basically my thoughts on the current competitive gameplay. Honestly, it's kind of a joke right now, and it has been for a while. I'm tired of having this happen to me, and I'm sure others are too, so I figured I'd go ahead and make a video about it. But what do you think? Tell me what you would change in this comments down below. Make sure to subscribe if you like the videos in this one, and head on over to my channel at twitch.tv/canvasgame for some content in World of Warcraft I could be participating in. Thanks everyone, and I'll see you in the next video.